Thank you, John. I'm going to come back to follow. Reverend Clergy, Grand Marshal, His Eminence Timothy Cardinal Dolan, and his 14 aides, Deputy Consul General of Ireland, Commander of the 69th Regiment, Colonel Flynn, past Grand Marshals and distinguished guests in the audience, ladies and gentlemen, and good evening to each and every one of you. And I want to extend a very warm welcome to you as we start the process for the 254th celebration on the streets of New York of our faith and our heritage and our culture. It's a long, long, long history, and you could read many, many, many books on what has gone on through the years. The parade has survived the Revolutionary War. We survived a civil war, two world wars, a depression here, many other conflicts, but the parade still is there on Fifth Avenue. 1938. Because of our depression that was going on here in America, the parade was 1 hour duration. The call went out to the Cardinal at that time when the schools and colleges came in, and through the war years we still survived. And in 1945 there was talk of cancelling the parade. There were so many of our people serving in our military, and the word got back to there was Congressman James Delaney from Queens. He was a confidant of President Truman's, and he had mentioned it to him, and the word was absolutely not. That parade could not be cancelled. It was a great morale booster for America. And he's the only sitting president that reviewed the parade in 1948. So that's a little bit of history for us, and it's part of American tradition, part of American history here. But to all of you, I want to thank you here tonight for this installation of the Grand Marshal and the Dates, 254 years on the streets of New York. I want to thank the Ahern family. Jack was one of the finest individuals, a great labor leader here, and unfortunately he got a little ill, and we're very, very concerned about Jack being able to march up the avenue. But we bent the rules a little bit, and going back a few years ago when we had our 250th anniversary, we had Mary Higgins Clark. And I said to Mary, I said, you know, it's 2 miles march up that avenue. I said, I don't know whether you'd be able to walk that distance, Mary, but we do have a golf cart. So Mary looked at me, she says, very indignant, she says, I don't want to go up Fifth Avenue in a golf cart. She said, I want to go up in a horse and carriage. And I said, that's a new one, Mary, but it's, you know something, I like the idea. So we did. Dominic Malone produced a beautiful carriage and had it shined up and everything else, only we didn't realize that there was no carriages allowed on Fifth Avenue. And the day before we had to get a special permit from the city, and he had to have the horse checked out by a vet to make sure that there wasn't anything on Fifth Avenue. But I tell you, Mary looked like a queen going up the avenue. And of course this year we're a little concerned with Jack, wouldn't be able to walk up. And it was a cold day, the weather, a lot of different things. But we decided to get Jack an antique car. Thanks to Danny Maloney from Liffey Movers, Danny provided us with a beautiful 1924 Ford car. I'll tell you a story about going back a number of years ago. Jim O'Connor from the Ford Motor Company, who was our Grand Marshal. And he told the story about Henry Ford set up a factory in Ireland in the 1920s, and he was invited over to open the factory. So he arrived anyway, and a delegation from the local council and everything came to see him, and they thanked him for opening the factory and everything else. And they said, Mr. Ford, you know, we're building a new hospital in Cork and we'd like you to make a donation. So he said, I'd be delighted and honored to do so. He took out his checkbook and I wrote a check for $5,000, which was a lot of money back then. So that was fine. The next morning, the headlines on the paper was, Henry Ford donates $50,000 to New Cork Hospital. So of course, the delegation was back in, all kinds of apologies and everything else for the mistake, and somebody misinterpreted and so on and so forth. And he says to them, he says, how much is this hospital going to cost? And they said, about $50,000. He said, give me back my check. He says, I'll write you a check for the $50,000. He said, on one condition, he said, I want an inscription over the door, the entrance of the hospital. He said, no problem, Mr. Ford, what do you want? He says, I came among you and you chucked me in. There's a million stories about the parade. I could write about two books on it. Some good, some bad, and all of that. But we do have, we're confronted each year with a variety of different things. There's no 2 years the same, but we have to put our heads together and we overcome many difficulties. But that parade is very, very important to each and every one of us. The largest parade in the world is recognized throughout the world. We have people from all over the world come to participate in the parade. We have a group coming from Galicia and Spain, from Asturias. We have a pipe band from Rome and Italy coming. And we're just down in Buenos Aires. We have the Irish Argentine Association going to participate in the parade. And a variety of people. This parade is recognized throughout the world as the premier celebration of our Celtic heritage. And I had the great honor and privilege of being in Asturias in Spain. I was up at Our Lady of Covadonga, up on the mountains, and I have a request, Your Eminence. The Monsignor is coming to the parade, and he asked me, is it possible that you can co-celebrate the Mass with the priests in St. Patrick's Cathedral on St. Patrick's Day? I said to him, I think that can be arranged. We'll get back to him. But absolutely, the travels there, we were in Lannis, and there was a small little St. Patrick's Church, not 50 people would fit, but we had Mass there, and they had the band outside with the dancers and the pipe bands and everything else. Absolutely amazing. I was at one of the pipe bands, the concert, and they put on a full performance for me. And guess what the band played? God Bless America. You know, you couldn't write about those things. You have to experience them. And indeed, I have, and I'm very, very privileged, and thanks to all the community here for giving me the honor and the privilege of being the chairman of this great parade. And Your Eminence, you're the third Cardinal as Grand Marshal of this parade. Cardinal Connor was the first, Cardinal Egan, and now we have Cardinal Dolan. So you bring great greetings and great honor and privilege to the parade. I don't want to go on too long. I'm sure you want to, don't want to listen to me too long, but you're anxious to hear from our Grand Marshal, Cardinal Timothy Dolan. So let me go over his bio, you know, but I don't mispronounce something here. Forgive me. His Eminence Timothy Cardinal Dolan was named Archbishop of New York by Pope Benedict XVI on February the 23rd, 2009. He has quickly become a beloved iconic figure, not just for Catholic New Yorkers, but for New Yorkers of all faiths and backgrounds. Cardinal Dolan's warmth and wit and his steady voice of wisdom, compassion, provides a welcome guiding hand to millions. Cardinal Dolan, a proud Irish American, is one of five children, and he was ordained to the priesthood in 1976. He has served as a parish priest, associate pastor, a Catholic scholar and professor for 7 years, rector of the Pontifical North American College in Rome. And on June the 9th, 2001, the 25th anniversary of his ordination of the priesthood, then Father Dolan was named Auxiliary Bishop of St. Louis by St. John Paul II. And on June the 25th, 2002, he was named Archbishop of Milwaukee. Cardinal Dolan served as chairman of the Catholic Relief Services and is currently a member of the Board of Trustees of the Catholic University of America. He was elected president of the United States Council of Catholic Bishops in November 2010. And on January the 6th, 2012, His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI announced that Archbishop Dolan was to be appointed to the College of Cardinals. You honor this city and parade with your acceptance of this role. Your Eminence, ladies and gentlemen, with great pride and enthusiasm, I present our 215th Grand Marshal, His Eminence, Timothy Cardinal Dolan.